Here's an interesting interview question I recently came across. Your mission, should you choose to accept, is to count bits. Not just any bits. You have to count all the set bits in a byte. There could be up to 8 of them. So, if you laid the number out in bits and counted each time there's a 1, how many are there? Can you do it? If so, how? In this video, we're covering 4 ways to count bits in a byte. Well, for starters, one thought might be to use the bit count function in the integer class. Easy peasy, done. In Java, you can answer the question with this. Ta-da! That's too easy. And it won't work. Not an answer. For starters, the question specified a byte. The integer bit count method takes an integer, pass it to a byte, and it gets cast to an int. What, you think that doesn't matter? Well, we know that minus 1 is a byte is 1111111, so the answer should be 8. Let's go try it. Create a byte, set it to minus 1. Print it out. The answer is 32. So it's counting the bits in an integer, not a byte. Since all numbers in Java are 2's complement numbers, a negative number is going to give you an incorrect answer. So we have to try again. Adding byte to the question makes this question particularly evil, especially for Java developers. Lots of casting. If you're at a whiteboard answering this, I feel for you. Still, we learned something from this. There's no built-in functions to answer the question, and we need to make sure that any operation we do use keeps things as a byte. So the next thought might be to just iterate over the bits and see what the count is. There's no iterator on a byte, so we'll need a different strategy for iteration. You know the byte has 8 bits. So, test the first bit by ANDing it with a 1 in the 8th position. Keep a counter for when the answer is not 0. So, for the first iteration, we AND the 2 numbers and we get the first bit. Since it's not 0, we add it to the counter. After each iteration, shift the test number by 1, and then we AND it again. Add that to the count and keep repeating. This is what the code looks like. This always runs 8 times. That's because each iteration of the loop tests 1 bit at a time. 1 byte is 8 bits, so 8 times. I think we can do better. Another option is the Kernighan bit counting method. That's Brian Kernighan from the Kernighan and Ritchie fame, you know, from the C language book. This algorithm will loop only for each set bit. So what we do is take our number and subtract 1 from it. Then we AND them. What does that do? Well, that clears the least significant bit. We keep doing this until our test is 0. The number of times we loop is the number of set digits. Once we hit 0, we're done. And the code looks like this. So this improves the count, but it can still loop 8 times if all the bits are set. We saw earlier that there was a method on integer to count bits. I wonder if we can use that and figure out a better way to count bits. Let's go try it. Here's the method in integer. Well, that looks like voodoo. And the uber helpful comment to explain it all. Well, actually it does. The comment HD figure 5.2 is referring to a book, Hacker's Delight. That's the HD. How do I know that? Well, I found it on the internet. There's no special insight other than that. But it does point us to the algorithm that's outlined in the book. The algorithm is this, and it's a bit mind-bending. First, you create 3 masks of bit groups. The first mask has every other bit set, starting with 0. The second one groups bits as 2 zeros and then 2 ones. And the last one is 4 zeros and then 4 ones. Let me color that to make it clear for you. The cool thing about this algorithm is the number of masks it to create depends on the size of the number that we're testing. The Java code in the integer class uses 5 masks for 32 bits. If a 16-bit number would use 4 masks, and then 8 bits uses 3 masks. See a pattern? Yep, log in. So at worst case, this is going to perform a set of operations log n times. In fact, This algorithm has the best worst case performance of any bit counting method. All right. Here's the algorithm. So we start with our number. For each iteration, we're increasing a shift we need to perform. So we start with 0. Next, we AND the byte with the first mask we created earlier. Save the value. Shift the number by 2 to the power of the value of the shift. So that would make the first iteration 1. The next loop would be 2, then 4, 8, 16, and so on. And the shifted byte to get a second value. Add those two values and increment the shift and repeat for the next mask. We do this for each mask. Let's work through one and it'll make more sense then. Start with minus 1, that's all ones. So our goal answer would be 8. We AND it with the first mask, shift the number by 1, AND it again, and then AND the result. We get 10101010. On to the next iteration, and we do the same thing. The only difference is we shift by 2. After we calculate everything, our result is 01000100. Our final third iteration, in this one we shift by 4, and we get 00001000. That's 8. That's the number we're looking for. If you look close at the intermediate results, you're going to see a pattern. The first answer has a number of bits by groupings of 2. So 2, 2, 2, and 2. The second result has groupings of 4. So 4 and 4. The last one is groupings of 8, so our final answer, and that's just 8. If you play with this with different numbers, you'll see that it's counting numbers in pairs, then 4s, then 8s, and so on. Here's the actual code. I don't keep a shift variable in this code. You might if you're counting bits in like a 512-bit number, but for 3 steps, it's easier just to unroll the loop. We run it, and we get 8. If we switch to 2 and run it, we get 1. The final way to show you might get met with some resistance in an interview. Still, this is hands down the quickest. Create an integer array for every single byte and store the count. That's 256 elements in the array. Just about any device could spare that. You're going to have an uphill battle convincing me that 256 integers is too much memory. Of course, you still need to figure out how to populate the array in the first place. You could spend an hour hand coding it. It's brain dead brute force, but think of the hours you'll save not having to explain the algorithm to your system architect. It's a lot of value in simple. If you need to calculate something larger like an integer or a long, use the built-in Java classes. It's the same thing as a population count algorithm. The only reason to not use it is if you know in advance that there's just a few bits set, like no more than 3. In that case, use Kernighan's bit counting method. That's much quicker if there's just a few set bits. And that is how you count bits. Mission accomplished.